Bottom line, at the end of the day, if you're not going to have fun today, there's something wrong with you. We all covet moments like this at Arizona, right? Every player, every coach, we're all in for 40 minutes. And again, locked in on that process of we're here to compete for 10 four-minute wars. I don't care if you're starting or finishing. Let's make sure that the biggest thing, we compete and we have fun. Jesse Perry, time's going to move quickly on you after today. You got six left. This is the greatest home court in the world. Let's take advantage of it. Let's get these guys.
Moments ago, inside the Arizona locker room with Sean Miller getting his team ready for this matchup against the Oregon Ducks. Head coach of the Ducks is Dana Altman in his second year at Oregon, 23rd year as a Division I head coach, 16 of those at Creighton. Let's take a look at the starting lineups. At first for the Ducks in the backcourt, DeVos Joseph, the transfer from Minnesota, joined by Garrett Sim, the senior up front, Jeremy Jacob, Tony Woods, and E.J. Singler. Now for Arizona, the three-guard alignment with senior Kyle Fogg, freshmans Nick Johnson and Josiah Turner, Solomon Hill and Jesse Perry, undersized but hard workers on the interior. Here at the McHale Center, 14,545. They pack the stands here. This arena opened up back in 1973. And out on Lute Olson Court, Dick Cartmell, Mike Littlewood, and Kurt Walker, the officiating crew here this afternoon. Ian Eagle, Greg Anthony, the rest of our CBS crew. And we are set for Pac-12 action. Woods will jump it up with Jesse Perry.
Ian, I think that the start of this game for Oregon is critical. They do not want to get off to a poor start and allow this crowd to get active.
Johnson on a bounce, Perry filling inside, and squeezes it home to open up the score. Half court set here for Oregon. Joseph for Singler. This Oregon team is coming off a 67-58 win over Arizona State on Thursday night. Joseph on a kick out. Singler works his way in, and the floater goes down.
Nice patience offensively by Oregon early on, and that's what I talk about, taking the crowd out of it, giving yourself an opportunity to have some success.
Arizona 12-5. It took overtime. 81-73 win against Oregon State on Thursday night. Perry tried to sneak his way in, and he's called for the travel.
Good defense there by Tony Wood, and that's a matchup, if you're Dana Altman, you got to be concerned about, because Jesse Perry's going to take you out on the perimeter and try to beat you with his quickness.
Garrett Sim. Oregon gets into its offense here. We're tied at two, a minute gone by. Singler lets it fly. Book it for three.
E.J. Singler, more of a slasher, but definitely has the ability to step beyond the arc and knock down the three.
Combo forward, a lot of versatility on this Oregon roster. Outside, Kyle Fogg off the mark, three-point territory. This is a guy who really worked hard on his jump shot over the summer, put up nearly 40,000 jumpers. And it's Garrett Sim the other way with a pull-up pop.
Talked about that in the opening. Transition, playing with pace. Trying to attack Arizona early before they get their defense set.
Oregon opens up 3 of 3 from the field. They've got a 7-2 lead on Arizona. 7-0-1 for the Ducks. Hill swings it. Working around the perimeter, Josiah Turner, the freshman point guard. Oregon will give you many different looks defensively. Turner on a jumper. And rebound controlled by Woods.
Oregon doing a very good job of forcing Arizona to have to shoot over the top and then also protecting that defensive backboard.
Oregon will score in spurts. They had a 21-2 run off turnovers in that win the other night over Arizona State. Singler is off the mark. They'll take advantage of your mistakes.
They really do. And the other thing, they're mixing up their defenses a little bit here early on, and Arizona thinking more offensively instead of reacting with instinct, helping Oregon out early.
Hill slashing towards the rim, ducks in for the deuce.
I'm a big Solomon Hill fan. I just think his versatility and ability to attack and create matchup problems on the floor, huge advantage for Arizona.
He does a little bit of everything for this Wildcat squad. It's 7-4 Ducks. Off the high screen, Woods releases. Work the shot clock now with Sim. Joseph in a matchup with Fogg. Good help there from Perry. Joseph forced to give it up. Woods unable to corral it. He tried to snare it with his left arm and a turnover. Fogg off the drive and kick. Extra feed. Perry attacking the rim. High off the window, Jesse Perry.
Love the ball movement on that play. But again, that face-up five, Jesse Perry able to attack Tony Wood out on the perimeter. He is not comfortable guarding outside of the paint.
Inside-outside ability of Perry and a turnover for Oregon on the travel.
Solomon Hill here, again, just very good footwork. Love the up and under, putting pressure on him. And then here, this is what you want. Bigs running out at you if you're Jesse Perry. He's able to get the little up and under and finish on the baseline. He's going to be big for them today, Ian. His ability to stay involved and be active throughout the course of the game, consistency, going to be very important for the Cats.
Tyron Merritt is in. A lob up top. Johnson's a high flyer, but he couldn't finish it. Here's Singler. Kick out for Sim. Able to fake out Turner, but unable to convert. Long rebound. Fogg tracks it down for the Wildcats. Oregon with a 7-6 lead. 4 minutes gone by in this first half. Arizona shot just 31% in the first half the other night against Oregon State. Perry, the floater rims out. It was halfway down, and he is going to the free throw line.
And you can see with Jesse Perry, the versatility. He can post up when he gets the matchup. And then also he gets the opportunity on a perimeter slash here. Beautiful footwork, just unable to get the finish, but he does get the foul. Arizona with a chance to take the lead.
Here's the week that was in college basketball. Brandon Paul goes for 43 in Illinois' win over Ohio State. Pittsburgh continues to struggle within the Big East. They got blown out by Rutgers. And Indiana loses its second game of the season as Minnesota defeats the Hoosiers 77-74. Here Thursday night, a scuffle at the end of the game. Arizona-Oregon State. Kyle Fogg is fouled on the fast break in overtime. Jared Cunningham the push. Fogg and Cunningham get into it. It nearly escalated. Kirill Natyapsko actually got thrown out of the game for Arizona. Joe Burton was ejected for Oregon State. This was all with a minute 15 left in overtime for leaving the bench. What was your reaction to what almost became a brawl out on the court?
First, Kyle Fogg as a senior has to have a little bit more control emotionally, but I give a lot of credit to what Sean Miller did. Mm-hmm. Remember, a few weeks back, he caught a lot of heat after that Cincinnati Xavier brawl with some comments that he made that were probably taken out of context, but that's how you really are able to try to subdue an environment in a situation that got a little bit intense, a little bit heated. That was an overtime game, and I think it's great that the league didn't have to suspend anybody. Again, you're going to have emotions flowing out here. This is an intense environment, but you still, as a senior in particular, want to have control emotionally.
This Arizona team is 3-1 in the Pac-12 with wins over Arizona State, USC, and Oregon State. Their lone loss coming to UCLA. Perry off the mark of the free throw line, 67% shooter. Oregon maintains the one-point lead. Ashulu is into the game. Missed it on the inside. Ball poked to the outside, and Oregon controls it.
Although Ashulu doesn't score there, I love that set that they run to get him at the free throw line, give him an opportunity to attack at the rim.
Sim using the screen. Jordan Mays is in for Arizona. Here's Ashulu, the transfer from Louisiana Tech, leading in to the banker.
And he's a difference maker for this basketball team because he's a guy who can consistently score with his back to the basket, forces that defense to drop to the level of the ball, and will create some three-point opportunities.
And a three-point lead for Oregon, now 4 of 7 from the field. Jordan Mays, the sophomore backup point guard, with Kyle Fogg. Bullet feed, it got deflected. Harum was underneath, hoping the ball would come to him, and it turns out to be a foul as Singler came up with a loose ball. So this will work against Arizona.
Yeah, but you take a look here. Their offense creates a one-on-one opportunity, and I like the fact that he attacks quickly before the defense has an opportunity to react there. And those are the types of plays Oregon's offense can create. They create a lot of one-on-one opportunities below the free throw line. Puts a lot of pressure on Arizona's defense.
Foul called against Mays.
Oh, my goodness.
It almost went down for Ashulu. He did everything right, but the ball bounced off. Comes the other way for Arizona. Hill sets it up. Fogg defended by Joseph. Angelo Choll, the freshman, is in there. Get it inside. Choll ducks under for the bucket.
Pretty footwork by the big fella. Nice feed also from Solomon Hill. Heads always up when he looks to attack off the dribble.
A long, athletic lefty. Oregon leads by one. All four Arizona field goals have been in the paint. Joseph, little fend off on Choll. Singler on a dump down. Ashley, look how active he is on the interior.
Footwork, you gotta love it. Again, I love the recognition by Oregon. They're trying to attack and take some of that pressure off of Arizona's perimeter defense.
3-point lead for Oregon. Just over 6 minutes gone by in this first half. Hill out front. Fogg puts it on the deck. Get it out for Choll now. Reset with Fogg. Shot clock is down to 13.
Oregon switched their defense. They've gone back to that zone, and Arizona a bit confused here in terms of how they want to attack.
Mays on a bounce. Fogg with five, with four, makes his move for the pull-up pop. Rims out. Choll came over the back on Singler, and the foul will be given to the freshman.
Good activity there, even though he picks up the foul. And then here, Osher, look at the footwork, able to finish up and over. I tell you what, he is very crafty down low, below the paint. And I'm telling you, you notice early on, Arizona, the best in the conference at defending the three. But when you continue to attack the interior, it's going to force that defense to help more. Look for Oregon to try to create some opportunities on the perimeter as the game progresses.
Ashalu had completed his degree. That's why he was eligible right away on the transfer to Oregon. Ashalu's jumper knocks it down. It's a three. What an impact.
The big fella is feeling it.
7 points now. The Toronto native, Olu Ashalu, fifth-year senior, 14-8. Oregon. Brendan Lavender is in the game. He was a standout in that victory the other night with his depth from long range. And another turnover. That's number three for Arizona.
And we talked about at the top, Ian, that focus and the defense, the changing of defense by Dana Altman's squad really creating some havoc for Arizona. They're just not very comfortable right now. No rhythm to their offensive flow.
Jonathan Lloyd is in. Diminutive point guard at 5'8", 165 pounds, sophomore from Las Vegas. He'll run the show here for Oregon. Ducks are 6 of 10 from the field. That includes 2 of 3 from long range. And Joseph hasn't even gotten involved yet offensively. Singler defended by Lavender, 10 to shoot. Singler, the hard drive, leans in for the bucket.
He's a slasher. I tell you what, I love the way this young man plays the game of basketball. He is always in attack mode. Oslo does a great job of screening out here. He gets in, uses the body, control, finishes up over the top. Oregon dominates.
Big numbers for Louisiana Tech. Over 14 points, 9.5 rebounds per game last season. Western Athletic Conference all-defensive team. And he has been a difference maker in this first half. A 9-2 run, forcing Sean Miller to take the timeout. Jump shot, Harrell. Count it for three. Kevin Harrell, the Bronx, New York native, knocks it down. And boy, did Arizona need that.
Oh, my goodness. Let's see if that ups the ante from a defensive intensity standpoint, and they can try to corral this Oregon offense.
16-11, Oregon. Joseph on a bounce inside. Off the back end, Jacob kicks it out. Arizona comes up with a loose ball. Harrell on a push up the floor. Lavender the extra feed. Arizona losses with to Mississippi State, San Diego State, Florida, Gonzaga, and UCLA this year. Foul called. Kevin Harrell will head to the free throw line off the wheel in the lane. Free throws when we come back. 5-point lead for Oregon. You can get real-time scores, live video, and breaking news on your phone. To get the free app, simply call *CBS from your mobile device or go to cbssports.com/mobile. One of the biggest stories in college basketball so far this season. Why don't you get to know 15th-ranked Murray State, undefeated under first-year head coach Steve Prohm. The Racers call Murray Kentucky home. wins over Dayton, Southern Miss, and Memphis. They're ranked fourth in the country in three-point shooting. Syracuse, Baylor, and Murray State, the three unbeaten teams in Division I basketball.
All have been really impressive, and particularly for me, Baylor. Remember, they got an entirely new backcourt. Brady Heslop, Pierre Jackson have come on and been spectacular. Perry Jones III finally living up to the hype, so very impressive.
How about the depth of Syracuse? Jim Boeheim can mix and match up to 10, 11 players on that roster.
Dangerous basketball team, and Jim Boeheim doing one of his best coaching jobs. And I'm really impressed with Syracuse overall. I tell you what, this is going to be an exciting year as we get deep into conference play.
Jeremy Jacob called for the foul before the timeout. And at the free throw line, Kevin Perry shooting it at 71% at the line. His offense has improved during his time at Arizona. Defensively can guard a number of different positions. Again, the versatility on this roster for Sean Miller. Arizona's 0 of 3 from the free throw line. One out of two for Parham. Substitution, Solomon Hill in. He'll replace Parham on the floor. Oregon leads by 4.
Oregon really hasn't gotten a lot done on the perimeter, but give them credit for staying disciplined and executing offensively and attacking a much smaller Arizona basketball team.
Jacob, quick turnaround. It rims out. Long rebound controlled by Sim. Sim, the jump shot short. And it's rebounded by Josiah Turner, the freshman from Sacramento, California. Lavender is shooting 60% this season from three-point range. He doesn't qualify in the national rankings because he hasn't taken enough per game. There's Perry. Jump shot doesn't go. Rebounded by Joseph. Just about at the halfway point of this first half. 16-12. Ducks leading the Wildcats. Working around the perimeter. Singler takes the opening. Bank shot. No. Foul called. He got hacked on his way to the rim.
And I love how assertive he is. That last possession, Jesse Perry, real hesitant on what he was going to do. No hesitation with E.J. Singler. He gets the basketball, surveys, and attacks.
Nick Johnson called on the foul. E.J. Singler, 89% free throw shooter. And he misses his first attempt. Let's check out the blog on E.J. Singler.
Well, we know he's the brother of Kyle Singler. This young man competes. He's a slasher. You've seen many examples of that here early on. And he's like a point forward. He's a very good decision maker out on the basketball floor.
And I'm comfortable to say he's got tremendous hair.
Yeah. Well, you're a hair aficionado.
Yeah.
I'm not as comfortable saying that.
You're not.
I'm not really into hair as much as you might be.
His brother Kyle has played professionally in Spain at Real Madrid, drafted by the Detroit Pistons. Working around the perimeter, 17-12 Oregon. Hard drive Turner, and he gets fouled on his way to the rim. Monday on CBS, get fired up for a showdown on a can't-miss new episode of Hawaii 5-0. Monday, only CBS. Now, Greg, Josiah Turner, interesting example of expectations for freshmen coming in, especially at the point guard position.
Absolutely. You know, it's so tough for the young man, and young men in particular, because there's so much hype surrounding their game, and they don't understand the transition. You know, you're playing against men when you get to Division I, especially on this level, and no one's going to give you anything. You're going to have to work at it and earn the opportunities, and it's nice to see he's starting to earn the opportunity by getting back into the starting lineup and getting the trust of his teammates to make the good decisions when he's out on the floor.
Highly recruited, coming out of high school. And Turner, his game is evolving. Definitely have seen improvement from early in the season into conference play. 17-13 Oregon. Singler, pretty spin. He's called for the walk. Arizona has had some tremendous point guards through the years come through this program.
Absolutely. And again, the other thing I love about it, it's almost like point guard you in a lot of respects when you talk about this. And that's another area of pressure that Josiah Turner is going to have. A lot of expectations to live up to what they've had here in the past.
Nick Johnson's been quiet on a kick out. Fogg, a little hop step into the lane. Rejected. Tony Woods is averaging a block and a half per game, the transfer from Wake Forest. Singler set it up inside for Woods. Got the height advantage on Perry. Soft touch. He comes up short, knocked out of bounds. Oregon will retain it.
And they rewarded the big man, but here He gets there late. I love the fact he gathers. You know, he doesn't go for the pump fake, and then he runs the floor to get down and establish post position, but unable to convert there.
Sims gets it in, and the bank shot goes down. Jeremy Jacob with his first bucket of the day. Oregon extends the lead. 19-13, Ducks. Turner. Spread the floor now with Johnson. Fires the three. No good. Good box out on the inside by Jacob, the senior from Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
And that Oregon zone defense is really causing problems for Arizona, just not able to get into any kind of rhythm here offensively as they come up with the turnover.
Oregon thought it was going to be a kick ball there. And it's Solomon Hill coming up with the steal. Nice cut to the rim. Josiah Turner showing off his quickness. His first field goal of the day. 19-15, Ducks. Into the corner, Jacob. Both teams shooting it at 50% from the field. Working around the perimeter, Joseph. Off the back down on Fogg, the turnaround, there's the height advantage. DeVoe Joseph at 6'4", and he can elevate the hybrid guard. He brings unique skills. Johnson, backdoor cut, doesn't get the roll. And it's knocked outside to Oregon.
Excellent execution there by Arizona, unable to convert. And Joseph, I tell you what, for a guy who leads him in scoring, I love his patience. He doesn't force the game. He allows it to come to him, and that's how you allow your teammates to get, I should say, have an impact on the game and get their confidence level high.
E.J. Singler pulls up. Sims spots up. Can't hit the three. Rebound. Oregon comes up with it as Hill was unable to secure. Jacob off the back end. Fans wanted a foul call as Jacob and Hill were going at it on the inside.
I'll tell you what, if you're Dana Altman right now, you have to be thrilled with the focus and the execution your team has brought on the road here in this basketball game.
How about the rebounding? 11-5 in favor of Oregon, and Dana Altman telling us before the game, I haven't really been happy with our rebounding so far this season.
Well, they have advantages here on the interior, and went for one of the few times this year they're taking advantage of it.
Off the Sim miss, it comes off of Arizona. Oregon will retain possession when we come back.
We talked about it at the beginning, losing focus. Take a look here. You're going to see not paying attention to detail here on the baseline out of bounds. Overrunning the play leads to an easy offensive opportunity for Oregon. They are clicking on all cylinders here early on.
Oregon's got the lead on Arizona. First half action will continue live on CBS from Tucson. ...21-15, Oregon in front of Arizona. So far, so good from an offensive standpoint for Arizona. 6 of 13 from the field. Oregon shooting at 9 of 19. The rebounding numbers controlled by the Ducks. Ian Eagle, Greg Anthony here in Tucson. There's no dominant team in the Pac-12. So you know there's this feeling out process early in the conference season of who is going to emerge as the elite team in the conference.
Absolutely. And the other thing about it is, you know, so much is made about the Pac-12 and how poor they did early on against similar competition outside of the conference. But what happens over the course of the season, teams progress and get better. You're seeing it today with Oregon. You know, they're playing some of the best basketball that they've played all season long. Because they're finally figuring it out. They've established an identity. They know what has to be done in order to win. And what did Dana Altman tell us? You know, he was a little concerned, a little disappointed that maybe they hadn't figured it out sooner. I tell you what, this first 13 minutes or so, they really figured it out how they have to play to win on the road.
This has been an extended possession for Oregon after a couple of offensive rebounds. Singler, Ashalu, again in attack mode, Ashalu. Going upstairs, missing on the dunk, but he's going to the free throw line.
They have run this set a few times where they get the pin down and they free Oshalu up at the free throw line to allow him to get into attack mode. Arizona has not made the adjustment. The weak side defense needs to slide over and take away that driving lane for Oshalu.
Foul on Solomon Hill. And Olu Ashalu, 56% shooter. He does get to the free throw line quite a bit because of his aggressive style. Oregon 12-5, 3-2 in the Pac-12. Wins over Washington State, Stanford, and Arizona State. Losses to Washington and Cal. 8 points for Olu Ashalu. Jordan Mays back in there for Arizona. Mays playing alongside Josiah Turner and Fogg in the three-guard set. 6.5 to go in this first half. Spin. Hill goes down. He got tripped.
How about E.J. Singler and his ability to be aggressive, getting into attack mode? He does a lot of damage, his ability to attack the paint, but he also keeps you honest by knocking down that perimeter jump shot. And we talked about this guy competes. He just gets after it, sets the tone, really, for this Dutch basketball team.
Turner, bottom on a three. Josiah Turner now has six.
Let's see if that three-pointer can get Oregon out of that zone, because it has created all kinds of problems for Arizona.
Ashalu lays it in. They cannot stop Olu Ashalu. He's in double figures with 10.
No ball pressure there. They allowed the cross-court pass, and then it creates that angle of attack for Ashalu.
Out front, Hill, under 6 minutes to play in this first half. Mays on a cut, tried to bounce it. Stop the clock with 5:50 to play. Thursday, see why Person of Interest is the People's Choice Award for favorite new drama. Catch a new episode Thursday, only CBS. Fogg triggers in for Arizona, 24-18 Ducks. Ball movement. Fogg in a matchup with Tyrone Nery. Timer is down to 7. Turner makes his move, swings it. Hill, the drive, blocked from the side. Merritt got a piece of it, and here come the Ducks. Sim off the acceleration. Joseph spots up, hands it for 3.
Transition, great defense, and Oregon one of the best in the conference at turning that good defense into excellent offensive opportunities. They're able to knock down a 3.
27-18, largest lead so far. Mays misses, follow goes, it's Angelo Cho. The freshman from San Diego, California, his family originally from Sudan, came to the U.S. as a kid through Egypt, got a U.N. scholarship, and has been improving as this season goes on. And there's the defensive presence. Ashalu goes down. Cho will get credit for the block. Quick ball movement. Mays can't hit the 3. Uncontested rebound for Sim.
Good sequence, though, if you're Arizona. The activity and energy that Angelo Cho has brought to this game really starting to stem the tide somewhat for the Cats.
Dana Altman calls out a play. Joseph relays it to his teammates. Sim defended by Turner. 27-20 Oregon. Joseph gives up his dribble. Merritt. Oh, nice bounce for Tyrone Nered, senior junior college transfer from Woonsocket, Rhode Island. And it's a 10-point cushion for Oregon. Turner, outside Mays. Mays the pull-up. Knocks it down.
And it looks like they're now figuring out how they want to attack the zone. Dribble penetration, trying to create opportunities. They've been consistent here the last few possessions.
30-22 Ducks. Ashalu took his eye off the ball, able to recover. Oregon has 6 transfers on this squad that are a part of the rotation for Dana Altman, including Joseph, who came from Minnesota. A bomb for 3. Rebound. Ashalu can't convert on the inside. And the rebound ripped down by Solomon Hill. Hill coast to coast. Doesn't get the roll. Offensive interference. Angelo Cho got his hand on it. Or did he? Are they going to count the basket or not? Officials are going to huddle up and determine whether or not that bucket will count. We'll let you know when we come back. It's an 8-point lead right now for Oregon. Monday on CBS, America's most watched night of comedy is all new from People's Choice Award winners How I Met Your Mother and Two Broke Girls to Two and a Half Men and Mike and Molly. All new Monday only. CBS. 30-22, Oregon leading Arizona. 3:11 to play in his first half. Coming up, AT&T at the half. J.B. James Brown, former college basketball star at Harvard, along with Seth Davis, who was not a college basketball star at Duke. All the scores and highlights, plus the latest college basketball news. It's all coming up on AT&T at the half. So for Arizona, trying to climb out of this hole. This was similar against Oregon State. Arizona had to battle back a bit. And they were fortunate to get into overtime. At that point, they dominated against Oregon State in OT on Thursday night, outscoring them 9-1 and holding Oregon State to 0-7 from the field. Sean Miller said, hey, this is a big week for us. That win over Oregon State, but we have to build on it and make it stick with a win here. Joseph back in on Johnson. Jonathan Lloyd has come back on, the sophomore. Oregon is led by as many as 10. Merritt. Back out to the point. 9 to shoot. Under 3 minutes to play in the first half. Double up on Joseph. They leave Lloyd free. Shot clock is down to 1. Violation.
One of the few possessions there where Oregon's offense wasn't able to create an opportunity. You can see here the balance. DeVoe Joseph, typically their leading scorer. Not spectacular, but solid. E.J. Singler and Olu Asuludo have really picked up the slack. And that balance is something Dana Altman has talked about being really one of the keys of their success when they play well. Because now it puts pressure on defenses. They don't really know where to focus. And that last possession, really one of the few times Oregon's offense unable to convert.
Arizona shooting 50% from the field, but only 18 attempts. Oregon with a steal. Joseph, 2-on-1, gets it back. And the layup goes down for DeVoe Joseph.
That's the way you run that 2-on-1. Nice little give and go there by Joseph. Off the turnover.
11 fast break points now for the Ducks. 32-22 Oregon. Parham on a kick out. Hill fights off Singler, and he got caught.
And that's a frustration foul there by Solomon Hill. And here you see great deflections, getting a hand in the passing lane. You can always get that ball up early if you're DeVoe Joseph, and it always creates that opportunity. Maybe you get it back, able to finish in traffic there. I tell you what, Oregon has been really impressive. You talked about Ian, this conference being wide open. Why not me? That's what Oregon's saying right now. Why can't we be the team to seize control?
Oregon 10-1 this season when leading at halftime, and looks like they're going to have a halftime lead here. Joseph, rainbow delivery doesn't go, and a rebound controlled by Hill for Arizona. Arizona looking for some fast break points of their own. Johnson the pull-up. In and out. It's been that kind of half for Arizona. Joseph, right down the middle. It's intercepted by Turner. Turner now on the push. And it's going the other way. Tried to get it to Lavender, and then Turner slid through.
He's going to make the point to Oregon. They've had 5 turnovers here in this first half, but the thing they've done well is they haven't allowed those turnovers to be converted into baskets. And here you can see that's a tough call there. I thought that should have been a little bit more inadvertent.
Josiah Turner.
The angle that the official had sometimes leads to calls like that.
3 consecutive turnovers for Arizona. Singler on a dump down. Off the turn, Woods got a good look at it. Tony Woods has just got a huge advantage at 6'11", and the biggest player for Arizona in there now is 6'7". Largest lead, it's 12.
The offensive execution of Oregon really hasn't allowed Arizona to play to their strength, which is to be able to pressure the basketball. Hard to pressure when you're executing offensively and not trying to beat people off the dribble. That's why you're seeing so many good looks at the basket for Oregon.
Sarcastic reaction as the officials call the foul on Oregon. First on Woods, 15 foul. Arizona with 53.4 remaining in this first half, and it's Oregon in front, 34-22.
Oregon, not necessarily a great defensive team, but when they execute offensively, it makes them better. And Arizona, as an excellent defensive team, they rely on that oftentimes to create opportunities for him offensively.
Woods swats it out of there off the drive by Josiah Turner. And that's the second block for Tony Woods.
And give the big fella credit here. He had his back to the basket, able to gather and still come up with the block. Boy, I tell you what.
Turner off the mark. And Perry got hooked on the inside.
It's funny, I was looking at the stats, and you know, Arizona is one of the better three-point shooting teams in the conference, but when you watch them play, they don't look like a type of team that should be as effective as they've been. And in this game, those threes aren't falling. And I tell you what, they're finding it difficult to create offense in other areas.
And that dangerous diagonal pass by Hill is intercepted by Lloyd. High pass handled by Singler. There's a 1.5 second difference. Shot clock to game clock, and Dana Altman wants a timeout. You're right, Arizona has made the most threes in the Pac-12 this season. They are 2 of 7 from three-point range in the first half.
Road and somehow winning one of the most difficult places in the conference to win. The confidence boost you get from that. And we talked about at the top, Arizona having to be focused for 40 minutes. How about 10 turnovers, only 9 field goals here in the first half? Clearly the difference as to why Oregon is in control.
This Oregon team has been up and down throughout the season. They've been up here in this first half. And a chance to put some more points on the board before the break. 6 to shoot. Singler with 5. Ashley with 3. Ashley makes his move. Swatted down. Nick Johnson to help defense with the rejection, and it goes down as a shot clock violation.
Nice play there by Arizona to come up with the block, but if you're Oregon, you don't mind that because those turnovers don't hurt you because they don't lead to opportunities to score for Arizona.
Glances off the hands of Kyle Fogg, and that's how this first half will end in Tucson. Oregon 34, Arizona 22. It's halftime. Right now, let's send it to New York. James Brown standing by. Take it away, JB. CBS Sports NCAA basketball coverage is sponsored by Applebee's. Resolve to have it all with Applebee's new under 550 calorie menu. Buick. See the stories unfold on the Buick Human Highlight Reel at ncaa.com/Buick. And by AT&T, get it faster with 4G. Rethink possible. Getting ready for second half action, 34-22, Oregon in front. Let's go behind the scenes. Moments ago, Arizona head coach Sean Miller met with his assistant coaches in the locker room here in Tucson.
There's two things. There's only two things that matter. To put the guys, A, who are going to play the hardest. And I mean compete at a highest level we possibly can defensively. Care of their names, I don't care if they're a freshman, I don't care if they're a senior. Who is going to play as hard as you possibly can? Everything to this point is irrelevant. And number two, on offense, we got to quit taking just jacked up threes. I mean, that ball's got to be pinging around. We got to get in the paint. A jump shot, I'm going to tell you this, it better be a wide open inside out shot. And here's the bottom line. It's a 6th war, a 7th war, an 8th war, trying to create a mindset we don't all get it back in one possession.
And there is Sean Miller. Good stuff from the head coach at Arizona. Now this team, Greg, trying to dig themselves out of the hole against Oregon.
Interesting, and he made a very good point in terms of how they're playing on their heels offensively. Yes. A lot of hesitation, a lot of reluctance, a lot of uncertainty. And if you look at Oregon, they're playing with that pace. And it's got to be, I think, if Arizona wants to win this game, that sense of urgency has to be brought about.
So let's check out the first half stats brought to you by Capital One. Field goal percentage, Oregon shoots it at 48%. Efficient on their three-pointers. They out-rebounded Arizona in the first half as well. Limited the turnovers, took advantage of the Arizona mistakes, outscoring Arizona in transition 11-4.
Really a dominating performance when you factor in they're on the road against a team that most people feel like has a great chance to win this conference.
Oregon with a basketball to open up this second half. Woods, short jumper goes down. Tony Woods, his second field goal of the day. And now Oregon in front by 14.
No hesitation offensively by Oregon. They know exactly what they want to do, and they have executed to a T here thus far.
It's a 14-4 run, bridging the first half into the second half. for Oregon. Hill trying to get more assertive, and it comes off the rim. Joseph pushing tempo for the Ducks. Singler swings it. Sim runs into Johnson, and they get Johnson on the foul.
John Miller talked about this being one of their issues. They shot the three poorly in this game, although they've shot it reasonably well on the season. I don't think that's really what they do best, and they were at times settling, not getting into attack mode. This is a team I feel like should get more opportunities at the free throw line because they attack the rim.
Second foul on Nick Johnson. He has yet to score for Arizona. Joseph off the back end and curl. Sim pump fake. Swing it out for Singler, defended by the freshman. Shot clock is at 15. The ball movement has been excellent for Oregon here today. Jump shot rimming out for Jeremy Jacob. Here's Fogg. And activity as this will work against Oregon. Perry was getting bounced around a bit, and Jeremy Jacob is called on his second foul.
And I tell you, Tony Wood has made such a difference. Now, I know he's only got, I think, two or three blocks, but he's altered a lot of shots, and he's really created an environment for Arizona where they don't look to attack the paint. Playing a big-time game for Oregon.
Who is going to step forward here for Arizona? That's the question. Will it be Fogg getting to the rim? And it's Woods again with his third block of the day. It triggers the break. Singler trying to get it back. Knocked out of his hands. Swings it for Joseph, sets the feet, and fires for two.
Love the vision. How about E.J. Singler coming up with the loose ball, looking cross-court under the baseline to find Joseph, who calmly knocks down the three-pointer.
It is all Oregon right now, 38-22.
Excuse me, two-point that was by Joseph.
Turner's jump shot, no. Hill on the inside, he cleans it up. 14-point lead for the Ducks. Just over 2 minutes left in this second half. Joseph, try to get it inside. Nice work defensively by Johnson against Singler. Double up on Sim. Singler cross court. Sim lets it fly at the three.
Ball movement. Pure and simple. Oregon's ability to execute without having to pound the basketball put so much pressure on Arizona. They want to guard the basketball. Oregon doesn't allow you because they execute with passing.
The senior from Portland, Oregon, Garrett Sim, blocked by Johnson, getting back defensively for Arizona. Knockaway Joseph getting in there and poking the ball away from Jatiah Turner for the turnover.
And if you're Sean Miller, you cannot be happy with the lack of intensity and focus in a situation like this. This is a critical game if you're Arizona. You can't ill afford to lose these games at home against the competition.
Singler gives up his dribble, 13 to shoot. Sim, who has been very consistent this season, gets it off for Jacob. Doesn't go down for him, rebounded by Johnson. Arizona pushing the pace there. Kick out, Solomon Hill, count it for three.
Now that's a good opportunity in transition because you got the penetration. Sean Miller talked about it at halftime. Inside out, that's the same as throwing it into the post if you attack the paint with the bounce.
Now can Arizona get it done on this end of the floor? Singler, Woods takes it straight in, bank shot, no. And rebound controlled by Arizona. Turner up the floor in a hurry. Perry getting a touch. Loves to take that baseline. Denial by Woods, but a foul call.
And that's how you have to attack a shot blocker. You have to go at his body with strength and get him off balance so he can't block. And you see here, the guys Arizona counts on to be effective offensively have been anything but here of late. Solomon Hill starting to get it going, but I tell you what, they have struggled offensively.
Second personal against Tony Woods. Arizona trying to climb back into it at home against Oregon. Pac-12 battle. Some surprises around college basketball. How about Georgetown? Picked to finish 10th in the Big East. They're 13-3. They're ranked 11th in the nation. Virginia, 16th in the country, 14-2. Best start since 02. And resurgent Indiana, ranked 7th in the polls. Big game at number 5 Ohio State tomorrow right here on CBS.
And then Michigan State, I tell you what, they've gotten really gotten their ship righted, but they are getting toasted today by Northwestern. K-State, really surprising how well they played. And St. Mary's, the WCC as a conference, much improved. They could get three teams, two at large, in the NCAA.
So here in the Pac-12, it's Arizona and Oregon. And at the free throw line is Jesse Perry, who is 0-2, senior from St. Louis, Missouri. Junior college transfer, the first one to transfer to Arizona since Lamont Frazier back in 1999. And this is on the first attempt. Goes one out of two. Arizona trying to chip away here. They were held in check offensively in that first half. ...41-28, Oregon. Sim, the jump shot, another open look for the Ducks.
Dribble penetration there by DeVoe. Joseph forces the help, and then Sim's able to dribble right into that mid-range jump shot.
Oregon has dropped five of its last six games against Arizona. Here's Hill on a hard drive and dish. Fogg lines it up, knocks it down, that's a triple.
And you know what, that's one of the first times today we've seen Arizona play for one another. The penetration leads to a kick that led to another kick. Rhythm jump shot by Fogg.
First field goal of the day for Kyle Fogg, the senior from Brea, California. Inside-outside game, Oregon turns it over. They tried to force it into Ashalu. Get it up the floor for Lavender. Fogg. And a kick ball. He's fortunate as he tried to bounce it for Jesse Perry.
Tough play there, trying to make that little pocket pass in traffic by Kyle Fogg. But if you're Arizona, at least you're starting to see a little bit more fight here in the second half.
They whip it around the perimeter. Inside, Hill lost it on his way to the rim. So they were able to probe against this Oregon defense, but Oregon recovers in the paint. Merritt, jump shot, DeVoe Joseph. So smooth, the perimeter presence of Oregon has been impressive, and he's in double figures with 11.
A lot of poise being displayed here by Oregon, and that last possession, crowd wasn't real happy with it on the penetration. Excellent cut and find there, but you know, I don't have a problem with that play there. Even Solomon Hill didn't really complain about it. I think it was just good quick hands by Oregon.
Arizona has 13 turnovers here today. Jordan Mays. Mays, a good ball handler. Kick out. Hill lines it up. Knocks it down. It's a three.
We talked about it at the beginning, him being their best all-around player. He's got to be a tone setter. You're starting to see Solomon Hill up the ante from an aggressive standpoint, trying to get this crowd fired up.
10 points for the Los Angeles, California native Solomon Hill. 45-34, Oregon. Joseph, high screen set by Singler. Sim has been so steady for the Ducks. Merritt puts it on the floor. Blocked by Hill from behind. Merritt sticks with the play. Shot clock down to two. Joseph unable to hit. Stick the jump shot. And the rebound controlled by Hill.
He just does a little bit of everything out on the floor for Arizona.
Lavender off the curl. Hill the jumper. It's a three, and here come the Wildcats.
Wow. Did he flip the switch or what? Solomon Hill making it happen here for the Cats. 13-4 run by Zona.
CBS Sports coverage of NCAA men's basketball will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
Not much call for Cowboys these days.
You would be surprised.
You ready to get back in action?
Doc's here.
Another week of live duty.
That's not what I'm talking about.
We're going to reclaim something that rightfully belongs to the Crowder family. I want you to apologize.
I got half a mind to kick
him. This is great country.
Justified premieres Tuesday, January 17th at 10 on FX.
You and anybody you care about are in danger.
This
this is a bad idea.
Hey, hey, wait, wait!
Yeah.
He did not score. Tebow time goes prime time. The Broncos battle Tom Brady and the Patriots. AFC divisional playoff action. It all begins with a special playoff edition of the NFL Today, presented by Southwest Airlines, tonight at 7:30. Don't forget, tomorrow afternoon, 1 o'clock Eastern time, with the NFL Today at noon. It's the number 2 seed in the AFC matching up with the number 3 seed Baltimore and Houston. The NFL on CBS. It's getting a little tighter here in Tucson, 45-37, Oregon in front of Arizona, and Solomon Hill is leading the way back for the Cats.
When things are not going well, you have to be able to rely on your leaders and your veteran players, and Solomon Hill has been doing it all here this second half. 11 points, knocked down 3 threes. He's doing it defensively, rebounding as well. Really, he has willed his team back into this basketball game.
Solomon Hill, who lost 25 pounds before his freshman year. And he has gotten more aggressive as the years have gone on. He's now a junior for Arizona. Two-time Pac-12 Player of the Week this season. He's the go-to guy for this squad.
Yes, he is. And I tell you what, if you're Oregon, you got to figure out a way to get DJ Singler going. He has not done much of anything, has not scored, had 8 points in the first half. Not as aggressive here in the second.
Sim with the leaner for Oregon, and that quiets the crowd down. At least for the time being, it's a 10-point lead for the Ducks. Sim now with 9 points. Baseline drive. Mays got bumped. And it was out of bounds. Sean Miller claiming there was a push. 14th Arizona turnover. Ashalu got the body in on Jordan Mays.
The fans don't like it, but I don't have a problem with that call simply because he didn't initiate the contact.
Oregon trying to add to its lead, 47-37 Ducks. Singler has not attempted a field goal in 17 minutes now. Joseph gives up his dribble on a bounce for Ashalu, turning on the freshman Troll. Kick out. Here's Singler. Gives it up. Sim with a shot clock winding down. And it rims out on a 3 ball. Lavender up the floor for Mays. They converge on Mays, and Oregon, good floor balance to get back. Lavender off the mark on a 3-pointer. Brendan Lavender, now 23 of 39 on the season from 3-point range, just under 60%. Sim being defended by Mays. Out front for Joseph. High screen, Ashley. Lavender got ridden off the play, able to recover. Shot clock is down to 10. Sim with 7. High screen, Mary. And a steal! Taken away by Solomon Hill, streaking to the rim.
Oh, oh my goodness!
It's Hill on a rack attack and a foul.
You don't think he wants to win this game? What a play defensively by Solomon Hill on the switch out of the pick and roll. Crafty coming up with the steal. And then you gotta love his body control. There, he just rips it away from Garrett Sim, and then he uses his body to shield Sim. Able to get the finish, gets the crowd fired up. Arizona not going away easily.
Arizona on the comeback trail against Oregon. CBS Sports NCAA basketball coverage is sponsored by Sonic. This is how you Sonic. Citibank, write your story with the City Simplicity Card. And by Ram Trucks, guts, glory, Ram. Oregon trying to hold off Arizona. Ducks lead at 47-39. And now let's take a look at the AT&T fast analysis, and going back to what we talked about at the top of the show, Greg.
It's been a game of two halves, really. If you look at it from Oregon's standpoint, they definitely play with a lot of pace in that first half, getting out in transition. But here in the second half, the focus has been there for Arizona, led by Solomon Hill. He has done it all here in this basketball, scoring it, 15 points. He's knocked down 3 of 3 from beyond the arc, 5 rebounds, a block, couple steals.
I tell you what, you talk about setting the tone and leading by example. This young man has done just that.
He's been a one-man show in this second half for the Wildcats, and he goes to the free throw line with an opportunity to complete the three-point play. His first free throw attempt of the day. Arizona as a team, just 3 of 8 from the line. 8-point lead for Oregon, 11:31 to play in this second half. Hill, a 74% shooter. And it's a 7-point game.
Now we talked about it. E.J. Singler, I think, has got to be a guy that gets a little bit more involved here offensively.
Joseph lines it up. Rimming out. Knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Parham of Arizona.
Bo Joseph is their best offensive player in terms of the guy you go to, but oftentimes it's Singler with the penetration and the slashing and attacking of the paint that leads to opportunities for his teammates.
Jonathan Lloyd triggers in for Joseph. Tight defense there from Favre. Joseph trying to circle. It's a 10-2 run for Arizona. Add some action away from the ball as Ashalu got into it with Angelo Chol. So double fouls assessed on Ashalu and Chol.
Two very physical players, neither relenting in terms of position out on the floor. Good call, though, by the official.
Plenty of time on the shot clock. Jonathan Lloyd swings it. Here's Joseph. Hard cut. Fog like a shadow right now. Kick out. Singler steps through. Rebound. Ashley's got it. Turns inside. Throws it up. No, but a foul.
That's an interesting play. That, even though E.J. Singler doesn't score, again, it's the activity. His penetration. It forces help. It creates offensive rebounding opportunities. You see Chol there hesitates. He wanted to go for the help. And that quick instant where he hesitates allows Ashalu to get in for the offensive rebound.
Two free throws here for Ashalu. High energy big man for Dana Altman's squad. And coming up Monday, Dave's all new with the mentalist star Simon Baker, Elizabeth Banks, and music from Seal. Followed by Craig Ferguson, only CBS. First one goes down for Olu Ashalu. He's got 11 points. On 4 of 9 from the field. One out of two. Chol picking up his third foul on the play. Might have been a lane violation.
Yeah, which lane violation was the call? I was interested. I was surprised. I was like, that's got to be a violation. It didn't look like they were going to call it there at first. That's a pretty obvious one.
Normally, you at least attempt to get that.
Yeah, you do. You do.
You show the effort to the official. Sometimes it's fake hustle, but in this particular case, Perry just camped out in there, and Ashalu will get another attempt. Off the mark. 8-point lead for Oregon. Josiah Turner off for Hill. Corner pop. Far. Off the rim, no good. Perry's fighting for it. And it's going the other way, out of bounds.
And if you're Arizona, you don't mind that as much because you get an opportunity, a rhythm look for Kyle Fogg, just unable to knock it down. And Jesse Perry there with great effort, extra effort, trying to come up with that offensive rebound to no avail.
Fogg is now 1 of 5 from the field. Hill is 6 of 7. The only Arizona player in double figures. And a foul called out front as Joseph made his move. Kyle Fogg unhappy with it. That's his first foul.
Tell you what, though, I'm a huge fan of Dana Altman's offensive execution. He created an angle of attack for the Bo Joseph on that play to draw that foul.
And a force out there as Parham was trying to D up on Singler. That's the 15th foul against Arizona. 14 fouls against Oregon.
Arizona kind of playing in stretches here where their focus and energy is great, and then they have those lapses we talked about at the top, and it's those 2-3 minute stretches ahead when you're playing comparable competition could ultimately cost you the game.
The other night against Oregon State, their guards scored 69 of the 81 points. And the guards have not put up offensive numbers here today. They get it in for Joseph. Fox sticks with him. Singler now. Plenty of time to work with on the timer. As we approach the halfway point of this second half, high screen from Woods. Lloyd, the cut down the lane. Singler lets it fly, and the three will go. Rebound tracked down by Perry. Arizona has 13 points from their three starting guards combined.
Oregon's gone back to the zone. Remember how much of a problem it created offensively for Arizona in the first half.
Hill hangs in the air. Perry, the offensive rebound, draws the foul. And it will be two free throw attempts for Jesse Perry at the line.
Jesse Perry, Kyle Fogg, Iron, and struggled here a bit, but Solomon Hill's picked up the slack here, particularly in the second half.
Third foul against Jeremy Jacob. And Jesse Perry going to the free throw line. Arizona, 4 of 9 from the stripe. Tomorrow in 60 Minutes, is Groupon the biggest bargain in the country? 150 million Americans think so. Plus, 60 Minutes has seen a lot of child prodigies, but none quite like this. The story tomorrow on 60 Minutes. Pair of free throws for Perry. This is now a 6-point game. 9.5 to go in this second half. Singler out front. Spread the floor with Joseph. Joseph, fend off, jumper, contested. And Joseph sticks it.
Tough play by the Bo Joseph. The defense was good. The offense just better.
13 points now for the senior Joseph from Toronto, Ontario. Oregon leads it 50-42. Turning inside. Hill, they collapse on him. Fall. Singler blocked up the angle. Turner on the move. Turner high off the window. Offensive rebound. Perron lost the ball. It was knocked away. Good play by Jonathan Lloyd, and then a foul called against Arizona.
Brown doesn't like it, but I think it's the right call there. Good activity. How about DeVoe Joseph here? It's important to have a guy late in shot clock to step back and quiet the crowd. DeVoe Joseph stepping up.
Foul called against Josiah Turner. That is his second. 16 fouls against the Wildcats. Lloyd gives it up. Singler off the cut. Jumper winning out for Jeremy Jacob. And tracked down by Jacob. Another offensive board as Sean Miller wants to send Angelo Chole back into the game.
Oregon, not necessarily known as a great rebounding team, has really dominated the offensive backboard. 11 here in this game.
This will be a giveaway. Did he touch it? Singler was going back along with the Wildcats and Parham.
He tried to shield Parham there from getting to it. Just did a good enough job of selling it. That's the right call by the official. That's definitely a foul. I know it's a loose ball. And you're both allowed to go for it. But you're not going to be able to kind of set the body block there that E.J. Singler did.
So the 16 foul against Oregon. Singler is called on the push. Arizona has it on the side. Singler will get a breather now along with Jeremy Jacob. Garrett Sim is in with Joseph. Also Tyrone Merritt, Tony Woods, and Jonathan Lloyd for Oregon. Turner, Fogg, Hill, Chole, and Parham for Arizona. Under 8 minutes to play. 8-point lead for the Ducks. Fogg, little shake and bake. Kick out. Here's Fogg. And it's pretty misdirection. It rims out. The foul by Parham. No. Fogg inside. He draws the foul. This Senior Kyle Frog will shoot two when we come back to Tucson. Oregon leading Arizona by 8. Game summary here in Tucson with Oregon in front, 50-42. The shooting numbers are down. Three-point shooting for Oregon. They have not been able to match what they did in that first half. Jordan with 13. Hill has led Arizona back on an eagle along with Greg Anthony. Pacing-wise, it looks like Oregon has been able to slow it down again and maybe get the style of play to their liking here over the last couple minutes.
Absolutely. They're playing ahead, and so they want to utilize the shot clock, but at the same token, I think it's a critical that Singler and Joseph have the ball in their hands down the stretch. But if you're Arizona, the activity level has increased. You're seeing them now starting to win the battle to the loose balls, and they're now getting offensive rebound opportunities. The question is there enough time for them to still pull this thing out?
Free throws here for Kyle Fogg, an 82% shooter, over 1,000 career points in his Wildcats career. The Pac-12 active career scoring leader for a player who didn't even think he was going to play in a big-time conference. Was not heavily recruited coming out of college. Got one of the last scholarships to come to Arizona and has become an integral part of the program. It's a six-point game, 7:38 left.
Big stretch here with Singler on the bench. You really now only have one facilitator and playmaker, and that's DeVoe Joseph. So let's see if Arizona can maybe create some turnovers.
Last touch as Turner went for the steal on that sideline against Jonathan Lloyd. Oregon will retain it. 26 on the shot clock. Get it in for Sim. Sim can handle the ball, as can Joseph, as can Lloyd. Lloyd's trying to get them into their offense here. Joseph out high. Fade away, doesn't go, and it's rebounded by Perry.
And that's one of the things I'm talking about. Those other guys can handle it, but they don't have the presence on the floor that force Arizona to have to honor them.
Joseph called on a push against Fogg. And that's 17 fouls now against Oregon. 1-1 coming up for Kyle Fogg, number 3 on DeVoe Joseph.
That last possession for Oregon was a similar play they had run before where Joseph got the step back jump shot. But they didn't have the same space there because there wasn't the same spacing on the floor. So Arizona picking it up intensity wise here down the stretch.
Kyle Fogg misses on the free throw attempt. And missed on the opportunity there for Arizona. Hard drive, Joseph. Foul called. It's going to work against DeVoe Joseph, and that's number 4 on the hybrid guard for Oregon.
And he's frustrated. And he didn't get the call on that step back. Felt he was fouled. He came down, committed the ill-advised foul on Fogg. It didn't cost him because Fogg misses the free throws. But that play, he just put his head down and looked to attack. He's got to regain his composure. It's about winning the game, not winning the battle.
Now to 6:45 remaining. Oregon 50, Arizona 44. Hill, high screen for Turner. Perry out on the perimeter. Shot clock is down to 13. Hill looking down low. Perry battling with Singler. Hill, little leaner won't go. It's rebounded by Joseph. They up the tempo, lob inside. The lay-in goes down. Good fill there by Ashalu. 6 assists for E.J. Singler, and Oregon up by 8. Down to the post. Perry turns. Bank shot doesn't go. Foul called. Jesse Perry will head to the line.
And this is the play here. Look at Oregon. Here the quick kick ahead. And you see Oshalu continuing to run the floor there. And Singler's head up, able to make that finish. You see the lack of transition defense there by Arizona. Very, very good basketball player. Oftentimes, Singler's got 6 assists. Again, just being on the floor really allows his team to execute offense. A lack of focus there by Arizona.
Third foul on Oluwaseru. Perry knocks down the first, and now Nick Johnson, who has been held scoreless, checks in. Johnson comes in averaging 10 points per game. His uncle, the late Dennis Johnson, the Hall of Famer, former star with the Celtics and the Seattle Supersonics. Leaner, Perry off the miss. And a wasted chances again. It turns into free throws for E.J. Singler, who shoots it as well as anybody in the country at the line.
I love the effort there by Jesse Perry, but just unable to execute and picks up the foul. And if you're Oregon, these opportunities now, they're in the penalty the rest of the way. And you talked about it, Singler, Sims, and also Joseph. Excellent free throw shooters, particularly down the stretch of game.
E.J. Singler, fundamentally sound, considered a glue guy for this Oregon squad. 89% shooter. Sophomore year, he averaged 11.7 points per game. He's upped it to 12.6 this year, but he fills up a stat sheet. He now has 9 points on the day.
Man, you made such a great point. And you call him a glue guy. There are guys that you can win with, and then there are guys like E.J. Singler that you win because of. Because he makes good basketball plays out there. He gives his team an opportunity. They trust him because they know his effort leads in quality possession.
Singler, the Medford, Oregon native, hits on a pair. He's got double figures with 10 points. Tony Woods is back in, and he has been a presence defensively, replacing Ashalu. Johnson off the double. Sim slaps it out of bounds.
And this is one of the areas for Sean Miller. When you have young players, oftentimes their jump shot determines their impact on the game. Nick Johnson, a very talented player, hasn't gotten involved in the other facets because I think his shot not being there hasn't allowed him to focus in those other areas.
We are down to 5:40 remaining. 54-45, Ducks. Lavender played such a big part on Thursday night. He has not gotten into the flow here. Hill with 7 to shoot. Lavender ball movement. Johnson lines it up. Counted, it's a 3.
Big time shot there by the young man. Let's see if that gets him a little bit more active out here in the game.
First field goal of the day. 54-48, Oregon. Singler swings it for Sim. We come up on 5 minutes to play. And a foul called. Naren with a ball fake, and it will be Solomon Hill. Coming up tomorrow on CBS, new bosses, new challenges, and the greatest rewards. All new Undercover Boss. It returns tomorrow after 60 minutes, only CBS. Third foul on Solomon Hill. Tyrone Naren, 69% shooter, missed it. On the front end of the 1-1.
Two possession game here.
Sean Miller's going to use a timeout. Oregon has been unable to shake Arizona. 5 minutes to play from Tucson. Indiana Hoosiers take on Jared Sullinger and the Buckeyes of Ohio State. It's a Big Ten battle. And we'll have it for you here on CBS. Indiana won the first meeting 74-70 in Bloomington. Well, this is inside the Arizona locker room, the championship trophy. It's in there. You're not getting it out. We've seen displays, but inside the locker room for every player to look at as they prepare for each game here at home.
What a great idea, because that should put that sense of urgency on you when you look at the tradition of that program. Each and every day you walk in that locker room, there's a certain level of excellence expected. There's the great Lou Olsen. Boy, I tell you what, we used to have some battles against his team.
Oh,
I used
boy.
To tell people I did not like playing Arizona because I respected their program so much, and I knew they were going to be a challenge for us each and every season.
You and Kenny Lofton went at it. Turner leans in for the deuce.
How about the body control of Josiah Turner? All of a sudden, 4-point game. Arizona has found a way to get back into it.
Wildcat fans come to their feet. 4:35 remaining. On the outside, Joseph playing with 4 fouls. Singler looking for high-low action. They'll dump it inside for Naren. Shot clock is down to 9. Joseph gets around Fogg. The cut. The floater. No good. Rebounded by Hill. Solomon Hill will push it up the floor himself. And now they'll settle in here. Johnson, one dribble and a jumper.
And I love the decision making there by Solomon Hill. And also, Nick Johnson not falling in love with that three-pointer.
It's a 7-0 run for Arizona. Wildcats have been very poised in this second half.
Not much call for Cowboys these days.
You would be surprised.
You ready to get back in action?
Doc said
another week of light duty.
That's not what I'm talking about.
We're going to reclaim something that rightfully belongs to the Crowder family. I want you to apologize.
I got half a mind to kick
This is great country.
Justified premieres Tuesday, January 17th at 10 on FX.
Did you know you can maintain healthy cholesterol levels just by snacking on a handful of almonds at work? They're crunchy, tasty, and they come in handy when your main job is to beat 18 bajillion times a year. Seriously, I'm like grossly underpaid for the amount of work I do.
If you're Oregon, I thought it was a really good possession last time down. DeVoe Joseph unable to convert on that little floater. But again, the right guy's taking the shots. But if you're Arizona, you gotta love the energy that they put forth here of late. Solomon Hill, I like the fact he hasn't forced the game. He got his team back in it. Now he's trusting his teammates down the stretch to make plays.
Hill leading the way for Arizona with 16 points. Joseph, the high man, along with Ashalu with 13 for Oregon. It's a two-point game under 4 minutes to play. Sim being defended by Turner. Sim, the fend-off. Shot clock is down to 15. Singler gets it into the hands of Joseph. A bunch up and now released with Fogg one-on-one. Joseph, take it away. Josiah Turner will take it himself to the side. We are tied at 54.
And we've been waiting to see that pressure defense by Arizona's perimeter all game. It's showing up in crunch time.
Oregon led this one 41-24 early in the second half. Sim the drive. Sim block. Curry came over to knock it away. Here comes Johnson leading the Wildcats. Johnson to the rim. He's fouled. Nick Johnson going to the free throw line. All knotted up. The freshman, Josiah Turner, getting it done on the defensive end. And the big finish. Right now, let's take a look at the Capital One Cup Impact Performance. And it is Olu Ashalu of Oregon.
Set the tone early on for Oregon with his interior effectiveness and really got them off to a great start in this game.
Now, right now, the question for Oregon is who can step forward, because they've gone through this stretch where they have not been able to get into quality sets. Being reset, Oregon with two timeouts remaining. The freshman on the flip side for Arizona. After Solomon Hill got them back in the game, the combination of Turner and Johnson making plays for the Wildcats.
Well, no pun intended, but they had been in a bit of a fog, both Turner and Johnson. But here down the stretch, they've been, you know, the difference makers, both offensively and defensively, creating turnovers, pressuring, forcing Oregon into tough shots, and then able to convert on the offensive end.
Arizona's only lead until this point was 2-0. And now they're in front 56-54 thanks to an 11-0 run. .257 mark. Looks like the timer didn't reset. It was not rolling. So now they'll put it at 32. Oregon will trigger in with Tyrone Merritt. Sam, they want to set here with Singler getting a touch. Singler, the cut. Singler banks it in.
Execution. Oregon finally getting back to what they've done for the first 30 minutes or so in this game. Ball movement and body movement
puts a lot of pressure on Arizona defensively.
12 points for the junior, E.J. Singler. We are tied at 56. Johnson swings it. Five on the crossover. 15 to shoot. Johnson the spin. Double team. Bounce pass barely got outside to Falk. Shot clock is down to 9. Falk takes a peek at the clock. Isolation against Sim. Fogg makes his move. Fogg, the leaner, short. Rebounded by Singler of Oregon. Now it's the Ducks that can take the lead with 2 minutes to play.
Not a good possession offensively if you're Arizona. Let's see if the rhythm is back offensively for Oregon.
Singler. Sim, two-man game. Singler for Sam. Corner's jump.
Got it! A three!
Money! E.J. Singler makes that play with his pressure and forcing the help, and Garrett Sim rewards him by knocking down the tray ball.
A 47% shooter from long range, the senior Garrett Sim buries it. Seventh assist for E.J. Singler, and Oregon has taken a couple of punches here from Arizona, and yet here they are with a three-point lead. Only senior on this roster to be at the school all 4 years for Oregon.
And I tell you, I really like the balance and the chemistry I've seen. Because let's face it, Arizona is a good basketball team. You knew they'd make a run and get back in it. But I'm really impressed with the toughness mentally of Oregon to withstand that. Win or lose, both teams have made a good account of themselves.
Off the timeout, this is Turner. A crowd Turner, and that will go down as a foul in the act of shooting. So Josiah Turner, a 69% shooter, pure point guard, going to the free throw line. Ashalu, that's it, number 5. So a huge call there. Olu Ashalu is done for the day.
Solid game for him. It'll be interesting to see if they come back with the shot blocker. Tony Wood, I mean, 13 points, 4 rebounds for Oshulu. Solid performance, because this is going to be interesting now with Tony Wood coming into the game. Because it could create opportunities, I think, for Jesse Perry to get back into that slash attack mode, which can force help and maybe lead to some perimeter shots. So let's see offensively how Arizona executes.
Turner off the mark on the first attempt. Been a roller coaster ride in his freshman year. Josiah Turner suspended twice. Sean Miller said since the last suspension, Turner has practiced as hard as anybody, and it's translated to the games. 1 out of 2 for Turner. It's a 2-point game.
To his credit, the young man Turner, Sean Miller talked about it. He said this young man's made great strides to become not just a good basketball player, but more importantly, a good teammate.
Mm-hmm.
Because ultimately, that's what's going to matter most if Arizona is going to have success.
1:22 to go. McHale Center in Tucson. Oregon 59, Arizona 57. Sim on the outside, defended by Johnson. They extend out on Singler. Sim comes to the ball. Shot clock is down to 10, 1 minute left. 2-point lead for the Ducks. Sam on a crossover. The scrape, the steal. Lavender takes it away for Arizona. Wildcats down by 2 with the ball. And a timeout call. Disjointed half-court set for Oregon, and Arizona creates the turnover.
Did you know you can maintain healthy cholesterol levels just by snacking on a handful of almonds at work? They're crunchy, tasty, and they come in handy when your main job is to beat 18 bajillion times a year. Seriously, I'm like grossly underpaid for the amount of work I do.
Not much golf for cowboys these days.
You would be surprised.
You ready to get back in action?
Doc's here.
Another week of light duty.
That's not what I'm talking about.
We're going to reclaim something that rightfully belongs to the Crowder family. I want you to apologize.
I got half a mind to kick.
This is great country.
Justified premieres Tuesday, January 17th at 10 on FX.
Now, as a shot blocker, been very effective when they've gone zone. But if they go man-to-man, then I think you're going to see somebody like Solomon Hill, Jesse Perry, with an opportunity to maybe attack and create for either themselves or their teammates.
Oregon up by two. Arizona with a basketball.
It looks like they've gone into the zone. Oregon.
Spread the floor. Fogg off the drive and kick. Jump shot. Turner missed it badly for three as Turner tumbled down out on the wing. Fogg is called for the foul as the shot clock and the game clock are all lined up. And now it comes down to free throw shooting for Oregon.
Oregon forced it there because it was a good look, but I probably would have liked to see Solomon Hill making a play in that situation. You know, he really hasn't been as involved here the last 4 or 5 minutes offensively for Arizona. And Oregon, give him a lot of credit, but that zone defense created problems for Arizona. Had him a little bit confused on that last possession.
Sam, an excellent free throw shooter, 85%. His first trip to the line today. 2-point lead. Sam, no good, and it's rebounded by Johnson. Johnson moves it ahead. Sean Miller will call the timeout with 26 seconds left to play here in the second half. Oregon up by two. Arizona with possession when we come back.
Timeout right there because you get an opportunity to attack a defense that's cross-matched. Now, the question is, if you're Oregon, do you come back in the zone or do you go man-to-man? Looks like they've gone into the zone.
Johnson blocked on the perimeter. Out of bounds with 17.9 left on the clock. It's Sim who came out extended defensively.
I tell you what, Derek Sim had got picked off on that play. Credit the young man for not giving up on that possession. Big time block.
Josiah Turner in, Johnson to the bench. 2-point game with 17.9 left on the clock. Outside, Fogg, 15 seconds left. Here we go with 13 seconds left. Fogg on a crossover. Hill swings it. Lavender a three. Short. Rebound. Tracked down by Fogg. 4 seconds left. 3 seconds. 2 seconds. Fogg with one at the horn. Off the rim. Oregon holds on here in Tucson. Big win for the Ducks. 59-57. A Pac-12 battle. And Oregon gets the win on the road.
What an amazing play down the stretch. Arizona, you know, it didn't look like they got what they wanted. A couple of excellent looks, though. Lavender, a great three-point shooter on the season, so they get good execution here. The drive and the inability of Fogg to finish. I'm thinking that was the first possession, but off the offensive rebound there. He gets into the lane. I like the fact he didn't settle for the perimeter shot. You could not ask for a better look.
Arizona, they got opportunities. They come up short for the Oregon Ducks. Big win in Tucson. The Ducks come into the state of Arizona. They beat Arizona State on Thursday night. They beat Arizona here today. That'll do it for Greg Anthony. This is Ian Eagle. So long from Tucson. The final score, 59-57, Oregon. AFC Divisional Playoffs. Tim Tebow, the Broncos, take on Tom Brady and the Patriots. It all starts at 7:30 for the NFL Today, presented by Southwest Airlines. Coming up, we'll send it to James Brown in New York with a road to the Final Four right after this message and a word from your local station.